HarperCollins presents How to Be Your Own Therapist by Owen O'Kane. Read by Owen O'Kane. To my partner Mark, who believed I could help many people through my books, thank you for your belief and encouragement. Introduction. I'm a therapist, and like most therapists, I've been to therapy. It changed my life. In fact, therapy affected me so profoundly that I was inspired to become a therapist myself. I believe therapy has the potential to change everyone's lives for the better. But here's the problem. It isn't cheap, it's hard to access, and there are often waiting lists spanning years. And let's not forget, there's still some degree of stigma attached to therapy. But if you're feeling at all hesitant, consider this. Sometimes our brains need a little maintenance and looking after to help us deal with life's challenges. And that's what good therapy helps with. It's nothing weird or freaky. I promise that you won't end up living in a forest or hiding away in a cave. Therapy is for the courageous, and what it delivers is true strength and endless possibilities for a fuller life. After musing on the challenges associated with helping people to get the therapy they need, I had a brainwave. The goal of most therapy is for clients to finish a block of sessions skilled up and aware enough to become their own therapist. So I realised that I needed to write a book that taught people how to do exactly that. Welcome to How to Be Your Own Therapist. I want this book to be a practical resource that anyone can use. This is not detailed psychoanalysis, and I say that completely unapologetically. I have the deepest respect for my colleagues who work differently to me, but this isn't a heavyweight academic clinical book. Instead, it aims to simplify complicated theories and make them usable in everyday life. The first half of the book will take you on a personal therapeutic journey before we get to the daily 10 minutes of self-therapy in the second half of the book. We need that first half, otherwise your daily practice won't make any sense. I like to think of the first half as creating a new you. It's like a crash course in therapy, or a therapy boot camp if you like. Second half is the daily maintenance. In this book I will teach you how to access the therapist within you and make the best of each day, whatever is going on for you. The skills you'll learn will help you to function better, feel better, and live better for the rest of your life. One final declaration that might come as a bit of a surprise. I am not going to change you. I am offering you my insights, learning, and experience. It is your choice what you do with it. Too many books, gurus, and professionals promise to change your life. I can't do that, but I believe you can change your life. About me. First and foremost, I'm a human being with weaknesses, vulnerabilities, and a back catalogue of mistakes like most people. I know from personal experience what it means to be imperfect. I believe this helps a lot in my line of work. I think we have too many people telling us to do more, be more, and buy more instead of helping us understand how we can live our present lives better and with less struggle. My other bugbear is how often we're told to ignore the warning signs that life is getting on top of us. It's all well and good being told you've got this, but sometimes we haven't, and we might need a helping hand along the way. I have a dual medical and psychotherapy background. Before I became a psychotherapist, I was a palliative care specialist. My final job in the NHS was a clinical lead for mental health in London. I now run my own private therapy practice in London, but I see clients from all over the world. I also deliver talks and workshops internationally on issues related to mental health. I grew up in Northern Ireland during the Troubles, a period of intense violence between nationalists and unionists. It was a challenging childhood. During my own therapy, I discovered that as a result, I was hardwired to be in a perpetual state of fear, watching out for the next problem. I've since worked in that. I'm also gay, which meant a lot of interesting conversations while in therapy. Being Irish, Catholic and gay was a conundrum for me. Catholicism in my formative years preached about praying the gay away, so it'll come as no surprise that some of my biggest revelations in therapy were that I tended to consider myself the underdog, and I regularly felt the need to prove my decency as a human being. Therapy taught me I didn't need to prove anything. Instead, I learnt the joy of self-acceptance. In this book, I will share the personal discoveries I made about myself with you to demonstrate what is possible with therapy. I'm talking about breakthroughs, transformation. I am confident you will realize both by reading this book. How does this book work? This book is divided into two parts. Chapters 1 to 5 make up part 1. This is the essential foundation work that sets you up for your 10 minutes of daily therapy practice, which is covered in part 2. You will need a notebook and a pen to do this work, so be sure you have both ready. Part 1 includes everything you'd usually cover in therapy with me. There are no shortcuts here, so I encourage you to stick with the work. It's life-changing. It will also help you understand the importance of your 10 minutes of daily self-therapy. In part 1, we will look at 1. Your real life story. 2. Making sense of your story and how it affects you today. 3. What you really want from your life. 4. How therapy can help you get what you want. 5. The essential ingredients necessary for a more contented life. I'll explain what I mean when I say your real life story, since this concept is at the heart of therapy. It's not simply your recollection of the events of your life in chronological order. What it means is sharing with another person the key events in your life that matter to you, and more importantly, how they made you feel. This will include experiences that are positive, negative, and everything in between. Often we tell ourselves and others versions of our story that are rehearsed or respectable to influence how we want people to see us as opposed to how we really are. I believe that most people adapt their life stories automatically as a defense mechanism rather than consciously. But personal development and growth only happen when we're able to accept the true events of our past and express them, together with how they made us feel then and how they make us feel now. That said, it's not just enough to tell your story. Your story also needs to be formulated so that you can connect how and why your experiences have impacted on your emotions, behaviours, and ways of thinking today. This will be the second step in your foundation work. Once you're able to do this, everything will become clearer. We can then explore what you want for your future and how to make that future a reality. There is no point doing this work unless it's going to bring some incredible changes to your life. Knowing what you want is crucial, otherwise you may feel directionless. Making changes to your life so your future looks different from your past will also involve letting go of some of the self-enforced rules you live by that are holding you back. Together we will work in that. In the final part of the foundation work, we will be looking at some essential techniques and self-care tools that you'll be integrating into your 10 minutes of daily therapy. Understanding who you are, why you act as you do, knowing what you want and what to let go of will open the way to a sense of calm, control and clarity. Chapters 6 to 10 make up part 2. This half of the book will teach you how to do your 10 minutes of daily self-therapy. Here you'll learn how to integrate techniques learned in part 1 into your daily life, and you'll be shown some new ones too. Both will improve your life for the better. This will be your maintenance work. You can do this for as long as you feel you need to. You might feel that you'd benefit from doing some form of this every day indefinitely, making it as much part of your daily routine as your morning tea or coffee. Your daily therapy is also an opportunity to work on the issues you'll have uncovered while doing the work in part 1. Here is a summary of what your daily 10-minute practice will look like at a glance. I know how demanding life can be, so I've split the 10 minutes evenly across your day. This way, no matter how busy you are, you can always make time to check in with yourself. The aim is that these therapy boosts will transform the quality of your day and ultimately your life. Ready. How long? 4 minutes. When? Preferably at the start of your day, whenever you can find a gap. I try to think of this time as like brushing my teeth. We all find time to brush our teeth for a few minutes at the start of the day, so why shouldn't we prioritize our mental wellness in the same way? What's it for? It's quietening the chatter inside your head and shifting your mindset into a more flexible, adaptive place that helps you get the most out of your day. Steady. How long? 3 minutes. When? After you've had your lunch. What's it for? Keeping you steady for the day and managing any setbacks that may have taken place, regulating how you think and react, and ensuring you psychologically look after yourself as the day progresses. Reflect and reset. How long? 3 minutes. When? Just before you go to bed, you're comfortable, you have nothing more to do, and you're undistracted by your phone. What's it for? Exploring the lessons from the day and letting go of unhelpful thoughts to enable a full night's sleep. The 10 minutes of daily self-therapy I teach you in this book will be life-affirming and transformative. They will also be a time when your entire life will be acknowledged and accepted with compassion. Having said that, some of the questions, exercises and suggestions in this book will be taking you outside of your comfort zone. That's unavoidable. Therapy should get under your skin, in a good way. But here's the deal. It works. Think of it as a decluttering exercise for your mind to help you function better. Different therapists have different approaches. I'm going to teach you how to perform self-therapy in a very particular way, a way that other therapists might not. In short, the views in this book are mine. What I teach here is not representative of the views of any one professional or regulatory body. Instead, the work I'll be taking you through in this book takes an integrative approach based on my various trainings and personal experiences and from knowing what works in clinical practice. It's also informed by a range of therapy models rather than one single model, although I've taken care not to get too technical and stick with straightforward language. The integrative therapeutic approach will, I hope, bring ease and a sense of stability. For interest, models of therapy used here include cognitive behavioral therapy, CBT, compassion-focused therapy, CFT, mindfulness, and interpersonal psychotherapy. For anyone with a particular interest in different therapy models, there's a lot of useful information online, particularly on the websites of professional therapy organisations such as www.bps.org.uk. I will explain fully every part of the process as I guide you through it in order, and I promise I'll avoid jargon, clichés and psychobabble as much as I can. I am asking you to trust me even in the moments when the questions I'm asking you may not make much sense, or if the process of doing the work makes you feel lousy. Therapy can be tough, but it should never overwhelm you. Work at a pace that's comfortable for you, and remember, there's no rush. You have the rest of your life to work on this. A final note before we begin. Throughout this book, I will share case studies aimed to provide support and help. It is for adults looking for a self-directed set of therapy tools to get the best from their day, their life, and themselves. It is also for teenagers with the support from their parents. Wherever you are at, it will help. But it's not a substitute for one-to-one live therapy, which some people will unquestionably need. If you do feel you need one-to-one or group professional support, please prioritise getting help via your doctor or local mental health organisations. There is a list of support organisations included at the end of the book. Please also be mindful that it would not be sensible to engage with this work if you are feeling very overwhelmed, experiencing psychotic symptoms, feeling suicidal, or don't have adequate support around you. You will need professional help in these circumstances. It is also not advisable to engage with this work if you are under the influence of alcohol, drugs, or any other unprescribed substances. Finally, all names, details and case studies featured in this book have been changed, and any individuals or organisations mentioned have been anonymised to protect and respect client confidentiality. Part 1. Chapter 1. What is this therapy malarkey? I'm going to teach you to become your own therapist and make therapy part of your life for 10 minutes every day. But before I do that, I'd like to talk about the shame and stigma surrounding therapy. I'm always intrigued when I meet a new client who says to me at the end of a session, "Wow, that wasn't so bad." It's usually men. I always ask what they mean, as the preconceptions surrounding therapy fascinate me, and as you might expect, I've heard a range of responses back. "Brace yourself. You seem like a normal guy for a therapist. It wasn't as weird as I expected." I'm surprised we laughed. "It wasn't all, how did that make you feel?" "You didn't seem shocked by what I said." You didn't hypnotize me. I thought you would just nod your head and say, I understand. It made more sense than I expected. It wasn't all tears and feelings. I was expecting you to be a twat.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.